Hello and welcome to this short video prepared by the Learning Experience team. This video will show you how to write an in-text citation for a paraphrase using Harvard referencing style. Paraphrasing means expressing someone else's ideas in your own words. When you paraphrase something, you express the original meaning of the idea used, but with different words. Now, when paraphrasing, it's very important to acknowledge where the idea came from by including a citation. This is why in-text citations are important. They allow your readers to link your main points to where the information was sourced. So let's have a look at how this is done using the Harvard referencing style. There are basically two ways to reference a paraphrase in the body of your assignment: an author-focused format or an information-focused format. Author-focused citations have the author's name outside the brackets. These citations are integrated into the sentence and are either at the beginning or in the middle of sentences. We use this format when we want to draw attention to the author. They may be an important theorist in your discipline or part of the required reading in your unit. Here we have an example of some original text written by Smith, who is the author. Smith states that students often find referencing in the body of their work difficult to understand and do correctly. Those are the author's exact words. That idea can be paraphrased into your own words and then referenced. Here are some examples of how this might look using an author-focused style. The sentence in the first example is, Smith argued that in-text citations can be confusing. So here is the author's name first, then the year in brackets, then the reporting clause, argued that, and then the paraphrase of the original idea. In the next example, note that the author has been integrated further into the middle of the sentence. According to Smith, in-text citations can be confusing. In this sentence, the reporting verb according to is first, and then the author Smith, then the year in brackets, followed by a comma, and then the paraphrased idea. And finally, in this last example, note that the author has moved towards the end of the sentence. In-text citations can be confusing, as Smith, 2020, pointed out in a recent study. The paraphrase comes first, followed by a comma, and then the author, the year, and the reporting clause. Now let's take a look at information-focused citations. In this format, the author's name is contained inside the brackets. This type of citation most frequently appears in the middle or at the end of the sentence. Unlike author-focused referencing, this kind of referencing is to draw attention to the actual information. So let's look at some examples. So here again is the original text by the author Smith. You can see that in the first example, the citation appears right at the end of the sentence. So I'll paraphrase first, it has been argued that in-text citations can be confusing, and then at the very end, we have the author and year contained in round brackets. This is followed by a full stop. It's important to note that there is no comma between the author and the year, just a space. In the second example, the citation is embedded in the middle of the sentence, so the paraphrase comes first. In-text citations can be a little confusing. This is followed by the citation, Smith 2020, in brackets. Notice again that there is only a space between the author name and the date. There is no comma. This is then followed by an additional idea, which poses a challenge for many students. When thinking about which way to reference in your paper, author-focused or information-focused are both suitable styles to use, and one is not necessarily better than the other. In fact, it's useful to mix it up a little and use both styles in your paper. Now let's have a look at how to cite multiple authors in text. When a work has two authors, the names are cited in the order in which they appear in the reference. So the first example shows how to reference a paraphrase with two authors using an author-focused style. Remember, an author-focused style integrates the authors into the sentence. So this sentence starts with the author names Smith and Jones and the year in round brackets. Notice that the word and is used between the author names instead of the symbol or ampersand, then the reporting verb, and then the paraphrase. The second example shows how to cite in text using an author-focused style when the work has two authors. Here we can see the first author's name followed by the word and then the second author's name, and then the year in round brackets. Now, if a work has three or more authors, the last name of the first author is only cited. followed by an et al. Et al is the Latin term for and others. So the first example shows how more than three authors are cited when using an author-focused style, which is integrated into the text. You can see that the abbreviated word al is punctuated with a full stop, and there is only a space between the full stop and the date. There is no comma. Now the second example shows how more than three authors are cited using an information-focused style. Again, the word al is punctuated with a full stop, and then there is a space before the date. In conclusion, when paraphrasing, use your own words to explain someone else's idea, and then reference the idea to avoid plagiarism. Remember, you can use information-focused or author-focused formats in your writing. Using both styles is a useful idea because it will add variety to your writing and referencing. We hope this video has been helpful, and best of luck with all of your referencing.